New Zealand sits on a boundary between two tectonic plates, and there's a very large fault, the Alpine Fault, which basically ruptures right through the South Island of New Zealand and accommodates most of that plate motion. The way that geologists have studied the fault is by going into the field and looking at the exposures of the fault in natural outcrops. And they've built up a picture, they've sort of pieced a collage together of how they think the fault zone structure is. Now what we're going to do is we're going to take a drill rig and we're going to drill a continuous set of rock cores through the fault and make a set of geophysical observations down that borehole. So for the first time we'll actually get all of the observations in one place going right through the fault zone. The first objective is to collect a continuous set of rock cores which will go off and be studied by all sorts of different techniques and people. The second objective is to put a suite of very sophisticated geophysical instruments down the borehole and make a set of observations, scans if you like, of the borehole wall. And the third objective is to install some very sophisticated equipment, including very sensitive seismometers, into the borehole so that we can create a fault zone observatory which will become a long-term monitoring station. At this stage, there is nobody really that can honestly predict earthquakes. And so in terms of how you live your life, you just have to go on living your life knowing that one day a magnitude 8 earthquake will probably occur on the Alpine Fault. However, it's only really in the last decade that these fault zone observatories and these very sensitive geophysical observatories have been installed. And we've already found all sorts of phenomena that we never knew about even more than 10 years ago. And so when we install this observatory, the honest answer is that we don't know what we're going to find.